വെൽക്കം ബാക്ക്. പ്രീവിയസ്ലി വി വെയർ ഡിസ്കസിങ് അബൌട്ട് സിമ്പിൾ ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റ്. വാട്ട് ഈസ് മീൻ ബൈ സിമ്പിൾ ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റ്? ഇറ്റ്സ് കൺസെപ്റ്റ്, മീനിങ് ആൻഡ് ഡിഫറെൻറ്റ് കേസസ് ഫോർ ഐഡൻറ്റിഫൈങ് ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റ് ഓഫ് എ പ്രിൻസിപ്പൽ അമൗണ്ട് ആൻഡ് ദ ഡിഫറൻസ് ബിറ്റ്വീൻ വാട്ട് ഈസ് മീൻ ബൈ പ്രിൻസിപ്പൽ അമൗണ്ട് ആൻഡ് ആനുവൽ അമൗണ്ട്. ലെറ്റ്സ് ഡിസ്കസ് ഇൻ ഡീറ്റെയിൽ വേരിയസ് ഇൻട്രസ്റ്റ് കമ്പ്യൂട്ടേഷൻ comes under simple interest pattern. Next case, Mr. A lent at simple interest ₹7,200 partly at 6% per annum and partly at 7% per annum. If the interest received after 1 year is ₹450, how much did he lend at different rate of interest? It's a simple interest question case, but you may find it confusing, but just go through the question very wisely. Here a person had invested ₹7,200 partly 6% per annum, partly 7% per annum. If the interest received after 1 year ₹450, how much did he lend at different rate of interest? Actually, in the question, the concept is that here a person lends some money, and by the end of a certain period, he got a total amount of 7,200. And the question, it is given that a part of that amount was lent at 6% and remaining part at 7%. I hope you understand the question. In the question, it may be due to some confusion or regarding the structure of the question. Actually, the concept is a person lended some money at differential interest. That is some part for 6% and some part for 7%. And by the end of certain period specified, it has already specified in the question, it is 1 year, ₹450. How much did he lend at differential rate of interest? In the question, it was you are asked to find the principal amount. What was the amount which he has lent at the beginning? So on the base of details given in the question, we can assume that let X be the principal of part 1. Part 1 means here the person has lent the same amount on differential interest. Differential interest means some part for 6% and another part for 7%. So let us divide that two halves into part 1 and part 2, and the principal amount relating to part 1 be X. And in the second sense, or in the part 2, it is said that the final amount which he has earned at the end of the 1 year is 7,200. In that case, if at the end of the period it is 7,200 and we have just assumed that the beginning amount is X, we can say that the principal amount for part 2 will be 7,200 minus X. I hope you understand why we did like that. Just imagine, if you have lended ₹5,000 for a period of 1 year, just imagine, lended 5,000 and interest for that certain amount is ₹500. So at the end of the year, you will have 5,500. And if you are given the details regarding end amount is 5,500 and interest is 500, you can definitely find the value of principal amount. Just deduct 500 from 5,000. The same principle used here. Here the principal amount of part 1 is X. So the principal amount of part 2 will be 7,200 minus X, because the total amount is 7,200. I hope you are following it. Next one. In the question, it is stated that total amount which he has recouped after 1 year is 7,200. That will be the principal amount of first part plus principal amount of second part. We have assumed that first part be x and second part be 7,200 minus x. So in the next part, in the question, it is given that total interest earned by him is 450. Total interest earned by him at the end of the period is 450. That 450 means 450 includes some part relating to part, some amount relating to part 1 and other half relating to part 2. So it can be written as 450 means interest of part 1 plus interest of part 2. We all know how to find the interest of a certain amount. So interest of part 1 is PNR by 100 of part 1, and similarly interest of part 2 is PNR of part 2 equal to 450. It can be written as, we know that principal amount of part 1 is x, we return into n already given in the question, it is 1. So no further cases, 1 into r is 6%, first part is 6%, so 6 by 100, plus next one PNR by 100. In the second part, the principal amount is 7,200 minus x, so 7,200 minus x into n. N is 1 year into r is 7%, so 7 by 100 equal to 450. By using mathematics, basic mathematics, you will get this part of the equation or bracket, you will get 6x by 100. That is 6 into 1 into x, you will get 6x plus 7 into 7,200 minus x divided by 100. Because there is no other further computation, 7 into 1 will become 7. Within bracket, it is 7,200 minus x. I just shifted 7 to the left hand side of the bracket. There is no issues regarding sign or some, anything like that. 7 into 7,200 minus x divided by 100 equal to 450. So since the denominator is similar, you can write as 6x plus 5040 minus 7x. Here the 6x is this one, and 550, 400 means 7 into 7,200, you will get 50,400 minus 7 into x becomes 7x. Since the denominator is same, we put 100 equal to 450. By using basic max of cross multiplication, you will get 6x plus 50,400 minus 7x equal to 45,000. So now we have 6x plus 50,400 minus 7x equal to 45,000. By shifting the known values to the right hand side and the unknown values to the left hand side, it will become x equal to minus x equal to minus 5,400, which can be written as x equal to 5,400. If the value means variable x equal to minus 5,400 is okay, then let it remain like that. Since it was here minus x equal to minus 5,400, we can write as x equal to 5,400. Now we have x. We already assumed that let the principal amount of part 1 be x. So we have got the principal amount of part 1, and we need to find the principal amount of part 2. So the principal amount of part 2 is 7,200 minus x. We got the value of x as 5,400, so the amount is 1,800. I hope you understand the concept. Therefore, we can found that Mr. A lent rupees 5,400 as 6% and 1,800 as 7% as interest. Next one, effective rate of interest. Actually, this area comes under compound interest concept, which we will discuss in the next session. For the time being, we will just go through it. Effective rate of interest is a case where that mainly uses the compound interest concept. Previously, we were dealing with simple interest concept. We know how to deal with simple interest concept. But when it comes to compound interest, instead of finding out a fixed rate of interest for each year, we find interest on the basis of computing the principal amount plus the interest preceding to that particular year. We will discuss about the compound factor in the next session. For the time being, let's go through effective rate of interest. Remember one concept. There is a rule that whenever the question relating to compound interest in this, sometimes the time regarding the amount or interest payment may be given as quarterly. Sometimes it will become relating to quarter, sometimes it relating to half year. Usually you come across these two cases. Whenever the question is relating to quarter basis or quarterly details are given, you need to do some adjustments in N as well as R. When the question is relating to quarter or quarterly basis, you need to multiply whatever the details regarding N is given in the question into 4. And at the same time, in case of R or rate, you need to divide the concerned rate given in the question by 4. Remember this concept. In case of quarters, usually you will come across quarters and half yearly cases. In case of quarters, you need to multiply the 4 with whatever detail given in the N in the question, and you need to divide the certain rate given in the question by 4. This is relating to quarters. And when it comes to half year cases, instead of 4, you will be using 2. For the time being, I just convey the concept. We will discuss in detail the further cases relating to quarters, half yearly and compound interest in the next session. For the time being, the equation of compound interest is A equal to, A means annual amount equal, principal amount into 1 plus R by 100 whole raised to N. Here in this case, find the effective rate of interest. The P is 100, N is 1 to 4 and R is 8 by 4. That we have computed 2. By solving this, you will get 100 into 1.02 raised to 4, you will get 108.24. So compound interest is 108.24 minus 100, you will get 8.24. We will discuss about the compound interest cases in the next session. For time being, just go through the previous sessions. That's all for today. Thank you.